Welcome to the math lecture series of class 11. We shall continue with our chapter linear inequalities. In the previous episode, we learnt about linear inequalities in two variables and plotting the given linear inequalities on the graph. Today, we shall learn about plotting linear inequalities in two variables simultaneously and finding the feasible region. We shall also learn about bounded and unbounded feasible solutions. And we shall deal with some real life applications of linear inequalities. So, let's try and plot some given linear inequalities on the graph and find the feasible solution. Consider the given system of linear inequalities, x plus 2y less than or equal to 10, x plus y greater than or equal to 1, x minus y less than or equal to 0, and x greater than or equal to 0, and y greater than or equal to 0. Note that the last two inequalities x and y greater than or equal to 0 mean that the solution should lie in the first quadrant where both x and y are positive. Now, let's consider these inequalities as equalities and plot them on the graph. We have x plus 2y is equal to 10, x plus y is equal to 1, and x minus y is equal to 0 or x equal to y. Let's plot them one by one. Consider x plus 2y less than or equal to 10. We first plot the line x plus 2y is equal to 10 and look for the region which has to be shaded. Substitute 0, 0 in the inequality, we get 0 less than or equal to 10, which is true. Therefore, we shade that portion of the plane where 0, 0 lies, that is, the lower left part of the plane. Similarly, x plus y greater than or equal to 1. We plot the line x plus y is equal to 1 and then shade the portion which is the required portion by substituting any point, say 0, 0 in the inequality. Left hand side gives us a 0 and right hand side has 1. 0 greater than or equal to 1 is false. Therefore, we shade the opposite part, that is, the right hand side, upper right hand side part of the plane. For x less than or equal to y, as we had dealt with earlier in the previous episode, we get the answer as the left hand side part of the plane. Now, putting them together on the graph paper, we observe that the region A, B, C, D is the required solution because in this region all the shaded portions lie. Observe that all the lines have this as a common shaded area, and we call this region A, B, C, D as the feasible region and hence is the solution for all the simultaneous linear inequations. Note again, we have confined our answer to A, B, C, D and we did not consider the region in the second quadrant because the last two inequalities given to us in our question were x and y have to be positive. Therefore, the answer has to be confined to the first quadrant only. Let's take up one more example, 2x plus y greater than or equal to 8 and x plus 2y greater than or equal to 10. Here, we do not have any constraint on x and y to be positive or negative. Let's again plot them one by one as we had done earlier. We first plot this inequality as an equality, 2x plus y is equal to 8. And shade the required portion by substituting a point which does not lie on the line, say 0, 0. When we substitute 0, 0 in the inequality, the left hand side becomes 0 and the right hand side is 8. 0 greater than or equal to 8 is obviously false. So, we shade the portion which does not have the point 0, 0 and hence the upper right hand side part of the plane is shaded. The second inequality is x plus 2y greater than or equal to 10. We plot the line x plus 2y is equal to 10 and shade the upper part of the plane because this is our required answer. Now, we plot these two graphs simultaneously on the graph paper. We observe that the overlapping region is A, B, C, D, E given by an unbounded region. Therefore, the feasible region is an unbounded solution to the given inequalities. let's take up some real life applications of linear inequalities. A solution of 8% boric acid is to be diluted by adding a 2% boric acid solution to it. The resulting mixture is to be more than 4% but less than 6% boric acid. If we have 640 liters of 8% solution, how many liters of 2% solution will have to be added? Let us assume that x liters of 2% acidic solution is to be added. Therefore, the new mixture is 640 plus x liters now, and the acid content in the new mixture is 8% of 640 plus 2% of x, that is 8 by 100 into 640 plus 2 by 100 into x. Simplifying it, we get 5120 upon 100 plus 2x upon 100. By the given condition, it is known that the mixture has more than 4% of the acid content. That is, the acid content in the mixture is greater than 4% of the total volume of mixture I have. That is 4% of 640 plus x. The acid content in the mixture we observed was 5120 upon 100 plus 2x upon 100. Therefore, giving us the inequality 5120 upon 100 plus 2x upon 100 is greater than 4 upon 100 into 640 plus x. On simplifying this inequality, we get 5120 plus 2x is greater than 2560 plus 4x. Transposing the terms involving x on the left hand side and the constants on the right hand side, we get 2x minus 4x is greater than 2560 minus 5120, giving us minus 2x is greater than minus 2560. On dividing by minus 2, the inequality gets reversed, giving us x is less than 2560 upon 2, that is, x is less than 1280. Let's consider this condition as condition 1. Now, the second condition given to us in the question says, the acid content in the mixture is less than 6%. So, as before, the acid content in the mixture is less than 6% of the volume of the mixture I obtain. That is, acid content in the mixture will be less than 6% of 640 plus x. Since the acid content in the mixture we had observed was 5120 upon 100 plus 2x upon 100, therefore, we get the inequality 5120 upon 100 plus 2x upon 100 is less than 3840 upon 100 plus 6x upon 100. On solving, we get 2x minus 6x is less than 3840 minus 5120, further giving us minus 4x is less than minus 1280. On dividing by minus 4, the inequality gets reversed, giving us x is greater than 1280 upon 4 or x is greater than 320. Now, combining the conditions 1 and 2, we obtain that the amount of 2% acid solution to be added should be less than 1280 liters and more than 320 liters. In these 4 episodes, we learnt about linear inequalities in 1 and 2 variables and how to solve them graphically. We also learnt about the types of intervals and the rules of solving linear inequations in 1 variable. We also observed the importance of linear inequations in real life. We shall in the next episode meet you with another exciting series of math lectures. Till then, goodbye.